Once again, this is Dr. Hatem Eleishi from Dr. Hatem Eleishi Medical Center in Cairo, Egypt. Types of medications that we use to treat autoimmune rheumatic disease patients. In order to describe the types of medications used to treat autoimmune rheumatic diseases, and in order to really see and appreciate the medical point of view behind using the different types of medications, I will need to start with a brief explanation of the sequence of events that result in inflammation in the joint, because those events are the target of the medications we will use. Just a reminder before we start. Do you know what is the daily routine of your normal immune system? It's mainly about fighting microbes. Here is exactly what a normal immune system is doing every day. Your immune system is made of officer cells, boss cells, manager cells, and soldier cells. The officer cells and soldier cells are concerned with fighting back against microbes that try to enter the body. Officer cells recognize microbes that try or that manage to get into your body. This recognition activates them. You see this red color now, they are activated, they become angry now. They take decisions to attack those microbes. And so they give orders, we call them go signals, to soldier cells to carry out those attacks. Now those are the go signals. We call them driver molecules of attacks because they drive the soldiers to make their attack. Soldier cells, having taken those orders, the go signals, proceed to attack. They have those guns that they use to shoot antibodies at microbes. That was the daily routine of a normal immune system. How about the daily routine of the immune system in patients with an autoimmune arthritis? Or an autoimmune rheumatic disease, you can call it either name, they are correct. For those who have the button for an autoimmune rheumatic disease that gets switched on, you can refer to video number 2 of this series for more details. So for those for you who have the button that gets switched on, the daily routine of their immune system changes. In addition to the normal thing that we just presented now, attacking microbes, the following extra routine also takes place. You have the disease button that you inherited. Those are the officer cells, those are the soldier cells, and those are your joints on the right side. They are happy, as you can see, because they are still normal. Nobody attacked them yet. So, you have the disease button. This button is switched on. You can refer to video number 2 for more details. The button is switched on. Look at the button, please. Oh, here it's switched on now. Now, switching on the button will activate the officer cells. They become angry now, they are activated, but not against a microbe. They are activated now in this disease condition, in this autoimmune disease, they are activated against the joints. They will attack the joints as if they are microbes now. So what they do? They produce those go signals that we call driver molecules of immune attack, and those go signals will induce the soldier cells to produce antibodies against the joints. When those antibodies are produced, the joints are no longer happy, because what happens when they are attacked by antibodies? They produce ouch molecules. When you're in pain, you say ouch. So they produce the ouch molecules or the ongoing inflammation molecules, and those ongoing inflammation molecules result in inflammation in those joints and in symptoms of inflammation. You see, the joints are inflamed. What are the symptoms of this inflammation? Pain, swelling, stiffness, and inability to use the joint. Like you see in this figure, the right knee here is swollen, it's inflamed, this guy is probably limping, he cannot go upstairs, this is an inflamed knee. In addition to the local symptoms of inflammation in the affected joints, some of the general symptoms of inflammation in the body are disturbance of appetite, disturbance of sleep, disturbance of mood, feeling emotionally stressed, feeling of fatigue. When you have those symptoms of pain and stiffness in the joints and those general symptoms of fatigue, you will find that it becomes difficult to do a lot of the simple daily activities. You will find it difficult to brush your teeth, to prepare a meal, to eat, to walk, to write, to take care of your kids. Simple things become no longer simple. This can, of course, trigger frustration and anxiety and even depression if those symptoms are not handled well. So, back to our model of inflammation, the officer cells, driver molecules, soldier cells, and the ouch molecules. Now I want to tell you the true medical terms for some of the expressions we just used. The disease button, it stands for what we call, it's different types of buttons actually. It refers to something called HLA types. This is more important to know here. Officer cells stands for T helper cells, the big boss of the immune system, and macrophages, the second man of the immune system. Driver molecules, or the go signals, they stand for pro-inflammatory cytokines. Soldier cells stands for several different types of cells, neutrophils, eosinophils, basophils, synovocytes, and the ouch molecules, the ongoing inflammation molecules, the pain molecules, they stand for inflammatory mediators called prostaglandins. So what can be the types of medications used to treat an autoimmune rheumatic disease? Well, treatment at this level, the disease button, can prevent the disease from starting in those who are susceptible to it. This area is beyond current management right now, but it will be an area for management in the coming few years. You can use this link to go to one of my lectures, The Practice of Medicine in 2030 onwards, but this lecture is in English and Arabic language. Now, treatment at this level, officer cells, and treatment at this level, the driver molecules, can control the disease and prevent its progression. Treatment at this level, the soldier cells and the ouch molecules can control the symptoms of the disease, the pain for example, but not the disease itself or its progression. So, let me tell you something about treating at the level of officer cells and driver molecules that can control the disease and prevent its progression. Since medications that inhibit the officer cells, T cells and macrophages, or medications that can inhibit the driver molecules, pro-inflammatory mediators, can control the disease and prevent its progression, we call them disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drugs, DMARDs. If you know this term DMARD and use this term DMARD, now you're speaking the language of doctors, you're speaking our language now. DMARDs, pro-inflammatory mediators. Medications, DMARDs, that inhibit pro-inflammatory mediators are mostly derived from living organism products in the lab. That's why we call them biological DMARDs. And so, we call the other family of DMARDs that act on the officer cells that produce those pro-inflammation molecules non-biological DMARDs. Non-biological DMARDs versus biological DMARDs. The non-biologicals are good initial treatments for mild and moderate forms of autoimmune rheumatic disease. And the biological DMARDs are mostly reserved for later addition to treatment of more severe forms of the autoimmune rheumatic diseases. So, we usually start here at the non-biological station and we proceed there if needed at the biological DMARDs station. Now, I want to tell you something about the treatments that act on the ouch molecules, the prostaglandins, the ongoing inflammation molecules, the symptoms, the pain. Since medications that inhibit the ouch molecules or inflammation molecules, in more medical terms called prostaglandins, only control symptoms and not the disease, we call them painkiller anti-inflammatory medications or analgesic anti-inflammatory medications. Painkiller anti-inflammatory medications come from two big families, NSAIDs and cortisones. NSAIDs stands for non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, and we have a lecture about them, and we have a video about them, and we have another video about cortisones later also. In the coming videos in this series, there will be a video about each of the three main families of medications that we use to treat patients with autoimmune rheumatic diseases. There will be a video about the officer cells, the non-biological DMARDs, about the go signals or the driver molecules, which are the biological DMARDs, and there will be one about the medications that control the symptoms of the disease, the pain, the medications that block the ongoing inflammation molecules.